Anything I can help you with?
Nothing I can handle, thank you.
What about the police?
The police?
Shh. Keep it down. They grilled me like a war criminal when I brought Allison back.
I've seen war criminals after questioning. They don't look like that.
Oh, for God's sake, all I want to know is how.
Said there's nothing going on that I can't handle.
Fine. Excuse me.
Eve, I'm sorry. I appreciate the concern, but maybe you shouldn't waste it on me. Have you looked in on her?
Yes, I have. She's very upset still.
Huh. Are things that you can't remember or things you can remember?
Both.
Well, Kevin Street, nurse in very good hands.
Well, she was in good hands on the way here, too. You calmed her down enough to get her here, and that's very good.
Now, let's give credit where credit's due. It's you who calmed her down. A lot of things, Eve, but warm and cuddly are not among them.
It's Dr. Lambert.
Eve, it's Frank.
Frank, where are you?
Route 9 past Craryville. How much farther to the cabin?
Not much. You're almost there. The sooner you get there, the sooner you'll be on Jamal's trail.
The sooner we'll get some answers to help Allison.
Allison is barely holding on by a thread. Let's just hope Jamal decided to go back there.
I'll find him, Eve, hell or high water.
Damn it, I lost his lights. Garcia to base, lost Scanlon heading north on 9. Target believed on his way to meet Jamal Woods. Advise all area units, hold it. I'm on him. Base, you copy? I'll let you know if we need backup. That is Frank, isn't it?
You bet it is.
And we're back in business.
Okay, Allison, you just relax. Let the drug do its job. Be sailing past those memory blocks before you know it.
What are you doing in here?
I came to tell Allison about the drug and how it was her only chance at recovery, which is more than you're willing to do.
And I already know her state of mind, and I've told you my opinion on aggressive therapy. And drugs are not an option.
I disagree, Kevin. The drug I use is a perfectly valid option in cases of blocked memory. What's the matter? Are you afraid I might be right?
What if you're wrong?
I'll stake my reputation on it.
All right, get out. You administered a drug without my permission?
I had Allison's permission.
You may have just put that girl's sanity at risk.
In your opinion?
You're pathological. I tell you, if anything goes wrong with this, I'll come at you with everything I've got. Allison?
Kevin.
Allison, it's me. I'm right here. I'm right here.
I feel so weird.
Allison? Hey. Allison, I gave you a drug. Remember? It's Dr. Locke. You gave me your permission.
Jamal.
What about Jamal?
To remember, I have to help him, and there's only one way.
Good. Good. Allison, can you remember the night Cedric died? Can you remember what you saw? Do you remember what you were feeling?
I'm there.
You're where, Allison?
I'm in the warehouse. I'm hiding.
Good. Good. Go on. Go on. What do you see, Allison? What do you hear? What is going on?
No. Oh, God.
Allison? Allison?
No.
Allison, what's happening? Allison,
shut up.
Please.
Allison?
Allison,
you gotta figure out a way to talk to us.
Get out. You've done your work, doctor. Get out. Get out. Allison.
No.
Allison, no. You're not in the warehouse. What you're seeing isn't real. You're in the hospital. You're in the hospital. Allison. I'm with you. I'll see you.
Stop it.
So far, so good.
You're absolutely sure that's him?
Well, why don't you speed up and check his plates?
Well, look, the last thing we want
is for Frank to know he's being followed. That's why you're gonna have to trust me, okay?
Yeah, we trusted you last time, and when we got to the warehouse...
Nobody was there. But this time is different, I know it. Frank is in that car, and he is on his way to meet Jamal. Bet anything on it.
Like that nice, juicy reward? Yeah, well, maybe Mrs. Barrington's gonna pull it now that her granddaughter's home.
Haven't you heard? She wants Jamal brought to justice. I really can't say I blame her. You know, Detective, there are some things even sweeter than money.
Such as?
Payback.
What's that?
Nothing, nothing. Why don't you keep your eyes on Frank, or you'll lose him fast?
Shoot, company.
I'm telling you, Frank's a really good driver.
Well, so am I, okay? So, whoa! Wait a minute,
Did you lose him again?
Quiet! He must have turned.
I told you
that... Try not telling me something for 5 minutes, would you? You talk too much, lady.
Tell me something. What makes you and Scanlon so sure?
About what?
That a mutual acquaintance of ours may or may not be at a certain cabin.
Well, after the police have already checked the cabin once, why wouldn't Jamal go back there? Because the police don't have the manpower to check it twice, right?
You hope.
I hope. Yeah.
Sorry to bother you two.
No bother at all. More stuff for me to sign.
But, oh, these? Oh, no. These are just a ruse.
You know, just in case somebody official was around. So, has Frank found him yet?
No, but we will let you know as soon as we do.
And after the way you covered at short notice, keeping you informed is the least we can do.
Well, I'm glad it made a difference.
Made a difference? Boy, she's as modest as you are.
Modest? Me? I think you got the wrong guy.
Oh, come on. Don't let him fool you, okay? It's all just an act. Believe me, this is exactly the type of guy that you want to have around in a difficult situation. And I know that for a fact. So you are just going to have to stand there and take it.
Like the saint I clearly am.
Well, the saint's a little strong.
It's a lot strong, thank you. The last thing I need is a hospital full of people coming to me when they think I'm some kind of a savior when they have a flat tire or a basement that needs cleaning.
Well, what about if they're looking for a second opinion?
Ah, it's different. Professionally, I am a saint. No, I shouldn't say that. I'm a demigod. So what's wrong?
A patient that just came in. I did an initial.
All right, what'd you find?
Nothing. She says she has tremendous back pain, but I can't find the cause for it.
Well, sometimes there is no cause other than evolution. We weren't meant to be standing upright.
Huh, speak for yourself.
That old familiar song.
Yeah. That's Kevin. He wants me to meet him in Allerson's room.
Okay, let us know, okay?
I will.
Allison, can you hear me?
No!
Allison, it's Kevin calling.
Please don't. Hurt me.
Allison, you're not at the warehouse. You're a general.
Oh, help me!
Rachel, I told you to get out. You've already helped enough to get out, for God's sake.
Please.
Now! Go!
I can't do this again, please, God. Separate me! Oh, God! Stop it!
I've got you.
Please! No!
Nurse Hartman, 4737.
Sorry.
Nurse Donna Hartman,
I've never had anything hurt so bad before. There's got to be something you can give me for it, right? Real strong?
You mean stronger than all the other well-known pain medications you already have taken. Notice you knew all the names.
Oh, for heaven's sake, who are we kidding? You want pills, don't you, Lisa? The strongest you can have and as many as we can give you, right?
For the pain, yeah.
Well, you wouldn't take them just for the fun of it. I mean, who would be crazy enough to take some of the most highly addictive medications available? Unless you were desperate for them?
Right. I mean, why else? It's got to be pain.
Or hunger. I happen to know how much better you feel if you were to take these, because I know how awful you're feeling for not having taken them. The pain has nothing to do with your back. It's your addiction.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, don't I? I took them for the same reason, and I always felt good for a day, but then it wore off. And then you're right back where you started from, feeling lousy and taking another and another until finding them and taking them is all there is. That's your life.
Okay, if you're not going to help me, then...
Why don't you start helping yourself? Sooner or later, you're going to find a doctor who's going to give you all the pills that you can swallow. But even if he doesn't charge you for it, that's a hell of a price to pay.
You know, you're wrong about everything you're saying.
Then why does everything you're saying sound so familiar?
Look, you may have had a problem, but that's your thing, okay? Not mine. All I've got is a backache.
I'm prescribing a non-narcotic analgesic and a number for a fine counselor.
Man, shove your number and your shrink, okay? You guys are a bigger pain than the one I walked in with.
Lisa!
You gave it a good try.
Yeah, for all the good that did.
Allison, can you hear me? Allison, it's Kevin.
Get your hands off me!
No, Allison, Allison, listen to me, listen to me, listen to me. Cedric is not in this room. What you're seeing is in your mind. Do you hear me? Do you understand?
Don't! You're hurting me!
Shut up!
Don't! No, don't! Don't!
Kevin, don't! What's going on?
Help me, please!
Allison. Get your hands off of me!
What happened?
Stop it!
Rachel medicated her and knocked her memories.
What? She's out of her mind!
See, what she needs to be is out of the profession. I'll get to that later.
Allison!
Allison, listen to me. Eve's here. You know her.
Get away from me!
It's Eve. Allison, it's okay. You're in the hospital, sweetie, okay? It's just you and me and Kevin.
Kevin, yes, it's me, Kevin. Kevin and Eve, we're here to take care of you. Do you hear me?
Kevin, what's happening to me?
All right, try and relax. Try and relax. Take a deep breath. Breathe out, please, breathe.
No, it's not.
No. What you're seeing is not real. It's not real.
It isn't.
No. Dr. Luck gave you something. Do you remember that?
Oh, gosh. Her heart rate is off. It's way too fast. Her breathing's labored. Kevin.
Don't hurt me again, please. I beg you, don't.
Okay. All right, Allison. Stay calm. It's okay. How long is this going to take to wear off?
I have no idea. For all I know, it's not even the drug anymore.
What do you mean? She can stay this way? What are we going to do?
I don't think there's anything else we can do. We'll have to admit her under a 5250.
Psych ward.
No, Lisa, no!
Oh, my God. Look at her.
Lisa, no!
For her own good, that's the only thing we can do.
No! Come on, please.
Stop it!
Hey, come on, man. Watch it with that thing.
What are you doing here?
Saving your butt. It's my new full-time job. Come on, the cops are right behind me.
Well, you brought the cops here?
Yeah, I stopped by the station and told them to follow me.
Look, what's going on, all right?
Grab your stuff. I shook the cops, but it won't buy us more than a couple of minutes.
Well, what's so damn important you had to blow this place?
Allison!
Well, what about her? Huh? Does she remember what happened or what?
You want them to catch you?
Fine, look, I'm moving, all right? Just keep talking.
Allison's starting to have some breakthroughs, yeah. Only what she remembers about Cedric getting killed isn't what you told her happened. And the more she tries to figure it out, the worse she gets.
Well, what happened to the doctors? I mean, Eve said they were going to fix her up. What happened with that?
That's why I'm here, man. They need your help.
What am I going to do?
I saw you that night, man. I'm the one that you called right after it happened.
So
remember?
What?
So I know how messed up Allison was, and not just physically. Only when I tried to ask you about it, you weren't in the mood for questions.
You know what? She needed help fast, okay?
Yeah, so... you know, and you used it that night just like you're trying to use it right now, but it's not going to fly, Jamal. Stop jerking me around. Whatever you remember the night she got hurt, you gotta start talking.
She's that bad, huh?
That bad. It's now or never, man. The cops are on their way.
I gotta see her.
What?
Before I say anything else, I gotta see Allison for myself.
Watching SoapNet, devoted to soaps and you.
Dr. Adams to cardiology.
Dr. Thornhart.
It's back to Thornhart, is it?
Fine. Ian, you forgot to sign every other form in all 12 of these files.
We only had 12 patients today.
13, actually, but one of the files is perfect, the one I spent hanging over your shoulder.
Oh, I see. Well, I'm vowing as a stand right here that all the others will be perfect, too, by the time the night's out. What do you say?
Great, you can start now.
I'll make a deal with you. I'll take care of this paperwork, and you stop whipping yourself over that teenager. He didn't fail the girl.
Well, I didn't exactly get through to her either. I was too busy sitting on my high horse.
You did nothing of the kind, Karen. You stood in front of her, and you let her in. You showed her you have the same dark spot in the middle of your soul, and that there is indeed a way out. With that, she'll make a choice. Same way you make a choice every day you show up here. Takes a lot out of a person.
What, is that supposed to make me some sort of hero?
To some. You know, I have a philosophy. At the end of the day, I like to let go of all my troubles. Old Irish tradition.
Well, sounds like a fine tradition. So how's it done for those of us not of the Shamrock Court?
It's very easy, really. All you need is good music, good company, and all the good food and laughter that a body can bear.
Sounds perfect.
Good. Get your coat.
What?
I'm taking you to dinner. You gotta start paying attention.
They don't need much to pick up a trail.
Don't worry. They're gonna take your nose and find a crumb in me your name, you know?
All right, let's get out of here.
Damn! Damn, what do we do?
Hold it! Nobody move. Hands where I can see them. Come on. Nice and slow, no surprises.
You better listen to him, Frank.
Courtney, I should have known.
Easy.
You selfish, money-grubbing little...
I am not the one who would run off with some criminal.
This is about the reward money, isn't
it?
That is all you care about. He is a kid.
He's a criminal.
I said that's enough. Take it easy. Hey, freeze the right
suit. Carrying...
Get out of my way,
Danny.
He's so close, Hank. He's gonna be back.
I know. Just lie down. Close your eyes.
I'm so tired.
That's good. Why don't you go ahead and go to sleep?
It's okay, Allison. We're right here, and the door will be locked.
Doing everything we can, honey. Just don't fight the tranquilizer.
No bad dreams, right?
Only good ones. Sleep tight.
Well, what now?
Depends on her system.
Kevin, if you'd give me a chance, I know I can help.
Any more help from you, there won't be anything left.
Well, maybe Allison would feel differently.
Allison's in a padded room. Not only to keep from hurting herself, but to make sure you don't try any more of your experiments.
I never intended for her to be
I don't give a damn about your intentions. Rachel, what you did to that girl was unprofessional, unconscionable, and possibly permanent. And I'll be damned if I ever let you anywhere near her again. It's all right, I'm finished with her. Be in with Allison.
Okay.
I'll see you at home. And I will see you for what you did to my patient.
Allison?
I can't sleep. I keep seeing him over and over.
Okay, let's try something simple then. When you can't sleep, when you're at home, what do you do?
Count
the sheep?
I can feel it. No, please.
No, Allison.
No.
Allison, no. Fight it.
No,
fight it. It's not real.
Please.
Allison.
Jamal, where are you?
Allison.
Please.
Allison.
No, please. Jamal. Please come on.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next Port Charles.
Want to go on?
You have the right to remain silent. If you give up that right...
This isn't what it was supposed to happen.
Well, then you are dumber than I thought.
Jamal, I need you. I'm going to die here if you don't come. Please.
Admit it. The day is never complete without your daily dose of Erica Kane and All My Children. Eventually, Erica will settle down and find someone special again. But is it today? You're going to have to watch and find out. Luckily, All My Children is coming up next here on SoapNet.
You never know who you'll bump into on All My Children. Coming up next, follow... This-